Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Hindi CBC Classroom. Please subscribe to my channel and hit the bell button next to it so that you will get notification whenever I post a new video. So let's move on to today's topic. Today's topic is class 9 chapter 2, Everest, Meri Shikhar Yatra. So Everest, my mountain journey or my mountain expedition. So let's start with the first page. So here in this chapter, the writer is explaining about her Everest journey, how it was, what and all challenges she faced, everything she is explaining from the beginning of her journey, from base camp till she reached the top of the Everest. So she was the first Indian woman to reach the mountain Everest or to climb the mountain Everest. She was the first Indian woman. So let's start, get started. So Everest Abhiyan, Everest expedition group started their journey on March 3rd. So from Delhi to Kathmandu, they went by airways. One experienced group had already started before them so that they can make necessary arrangements before they reach the base camp. Namche Bazaar was a popular town in Sherpa land. It is a place in Nepal. Most of the Sherpa is a community of people in Nepal, were found around the city only. Most of the Sherpas were found around the city. So it was Namche Bazaar where the writer saw the great Everest for the first time. The place is also known as Sagar Mata. Everest is called Sagar Mata among the Nepalese. So she liked that name. When the writer looked at the Everest, she noticed that there was a plume all over the Everest mountain. Plume is that like a white fog like thing. When you see a mountain, no, there will be a cover like in the air. It will be like white fog like substance on the mountain. So she noticed there is a very huge plume all over the Everest mountain. So when writer asked the people around then that what is it, she got to know that this was a wind above the mountain. The wind above the mountain flows at a speed of 150 km per hour or even more. So because of that, what happened? The dry ice flakes keep on flying around all the time. And thus, it will give a sight or it is seen as a cloud or fog from here down. शिखर पर जाने वाले पीपल हु हाइक और हु क्लाइम ऑन द एवरेस्ट इन द साउथ ईस्ट डायरेक्शन हैव टू क्रॉस थ्रू दिस एंड व्हेन द क्लाइमेट इज नॉट सो गुड इट बिकम्स वेरी वेरी टफ बिकॉज ऑफ दिस प्ल्यूम दिस वॉज इनफ टू स्केयर हर बट स्टिल द राइटर वॉज अट्रैक्टेड टू द एवरेस्ट एंड शी वॉन्टेड टू फेस द डिफिकल्ट चैलेंजेस ऑन द वे ऑन 26th March व्हेन दे रीच्ड पायरिच She got means their team got a sad news that one of their Sherpa helper had passed away, had lost his life because of the avalanche or snow slide, what you say, because of some shake in some mountain in Khumbu Glacier, a big piece of ice had rolled on their path and that had caused the death of one of the Sherpa helper. After out of 16, there were 16 Sherpa coolies. Coolies means people who carry the luggages, no? So there were 16 Sherpa coolies. Among them, one died and four of them got injured. After hearing this, the whole team panicked and seeing that their leader, Colonel Khullar, said, what he said, in a great journey like an Everest, we should have the strength to accept difficulties and sometimes even we have to face death. Upaneta Premchand, leader Premchand, who was leading the experienced group, he came back to Pyrich on 26th March. He came back to tell them all the challenges they would have to face on the path of Khumbu Glacier. Then he also mentioned that they have cleared the way for them and they have also checked with all the ways available and confirmed that now it's safe to go for them. He also informed that they have put a camp on 6000 meter which is above the mountain and have cleared the path till that. But there is a possibility. He also mentioned that if there is a possibility that we have to clear the path again because the snow slides, you know, are unpredictable and unexpected. So it is common here that a snow slide may happen at any time. So if some snow slide will happen, we have to clean the way ourselves. So before reaching the base camp, they got a sad news again that because some climate was not good, a chef has lost his life. After that, all the members were horrified and they all had lost some hope because they were scared now who's next. The writer had seen the Everest twice, but from some distance. The second day after reaching the base camp, she saw the Everest for the first time. It was so attractive. It was so attractive and she just kept staring at the beauty of the Everest and all the rivers that were flowing in a zigzag way. The whole scene was breathtaking. So the snow slides are caused because of the glaciers flowing between them only, because these glaciers, these rivers, what they make some movement, and because of that the snow starts rolling and shaking and falls off, which results in snow slides, and that causes dangerous situations for the climbers. The thought of all these shakes and that turning into snow slides or avalanche itself scared the writer. More than this, the scariest thing was that it was sure that a dozen of climbers or helpers would be hit by these slides on the whole journey. So it was scary because it can cause even death. So they were getting scared because there was a possibility of high risk in this whole journey. The second day, they managed to make most of their luggage or necessity halfway. They managed to take it to the halfway. Dr. Meenu Mehta taught them how to make like a temporary bridge with aluminium steps, how to use ropes on the mountains, and also explain the developments and innovations that is made by the advanced climber groups. The third day, they had to climb the mountain with their luggages to camp one. The writer and Rita Gombu, they were climbing together. They also had a walkie-talkie with them, which they used to communicate with the base camp. Colonel Kuller became so happy when he was informed that they have reached this. Rita Gombu and writer have reached camp one. They were the only two ladies who reached camp one. Ang Dorji Lopsang or Gagan Bista and Gagan Bista team reached South Col. South Col is a place in Everest expedition. On 29th April, they made a camp 4 on a height of 7,900 meters. It was a successful progress because on 29th March itself, they had reached camp 4. In April, when they were in base camp, Tenzing came with his youngest daughter to meet them all. He made sure that he meets all the climbers and helpers individually. So when the writer's turn came, she introduced herself as a newcomer. Newcomer or what? This is the first time she is doing a mountain climbing. So it was her first expedition. So Tenzing laughed and said even for him, Everest was his first expedition. But he also mentioned that but to reach the top, he had to climb it 7 times. Because at first go, it is very tough to climb an Everest. It needs practice. So it took him 7 times to reach the top of the Everest. Then he tapped on her back and said, but I feel you can climb it at the first go as you look like a mountain girl. So that was a inspiration, or that was a what we say, it will encouragement. It was an encouragement for the writer. On 16th May 1984, she was in a camp 3 on a full moon day, all were in a tent made of beautiful nylon cloth on Lhotsa Plain Mountain. So there were 10 more people in the camp. कैंप 3 में थी, कैंप में 10 और व्यक्ति थे, सो देर वेर 10 मोर पीपल इन द कैंप. लोसंग तसरांग दे वेर ऑल इन हर टेंप हर टेंट एंड एनडी शेरपा एंड रेस्ट ऑफ द स्ट्रांग शेरपा पीपल दे वेर इन अनदर टेंट्स. सो शी वॉज फास्ट एस्लीप बट एट 12:30 AM समथिंग स्ट्रांग एंड कोल्ड हिट हर हेड स्ट्रांगली and she woke up. She felt as if something strong and cold is rolling over her and she couldn't breathe. ये क्या हो गया था? What had happened? A big ice piece had broken and rolled down from the mountain, forming a giant ice ball. And now it had landed on their camp. This big ball had destroyed their camp totally. Every single person on the camp was injured. But it was shocking that no one lost his life. Lobsang tried to tear the tent and he tried to save the writer. If she would get stuck for a little time more, that means death. So somehow he dug out all the big pieces or big chunks of ice and succeeded in pulling her out. सुबह तक सारे सुरक्षा मॉर्निंग ऑल द सेफ्टी मेंबर्स केम एंड ऑन 16th मई अराउंड 8 AM दे ऑल रीच्ड कैंप टू दे केम बैक टू कैंप टू द शेरपा हु हैड ब्रोकन हिज लेग वन ऑफ द शेरपा हैड ब्रोकन हिज लेग ही वॉज ब्रॉड डाउन इन अ सेल्फ मेड स्ट्रक्चर कर्नल कुलर सेड एट दिस हाइट इट वॉज अ ग्रेट वर्क डन बाय द सेफ्टी टीम सभी नौ ऑल द 9 मेल मेंबर्स वेर टेकन डाउन टू बेस कैंप बिकॉज ऑफ आइदर ब्रोकन बोन्स और मेजर इंजरीज एक्सेट्रा सो कर्नल कुलर आज द राइटर आर यू स्कैर्ड शी सेड येस सो ही आज डू यू वॉन्ट टू गो बैक द राइटर सेड नो 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 आई डोंट वॉन्ट टू गो बैक एंड शी वॉज वेरी फर्म ऑन इट जैसे ही मैं वेन द राइटर रीच्ड साउथ कॉल कैंप द वेरी नेक्स्ट डे शी स्टार्टेड हर मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट जर्नी She collected food, cooking gas, and oxygen cylinder. Afternoon at 1:30, Bissa came. There is one of the co-members of her team. And he saw her making tea. Ki, Jay, and Meenu were very behind. She was worried because she had to start climbing the next day with them only. So they haven't yet made. So she was a little worried. They were climbing very slowly as they were climbing without the oxygen tanks. These three people, they were climbing without the oxygen tanks. So it was taking time for them. दोपहर बाद मैंने afternoon she started helping other members in the camp. Then she decided to go down and check on them. This Kijay and Meenu, she wanted to check on them how they are doing. So what she did, she took two flasks and she filled one with juice and one with tea for them so that they will feel good. Then she stepped outside of the camp in a very icy wind. When she was just stepping out of the camp, she saw Meenu. So he had reached. Ki and Jay were not with him. So they were left behind. So she went further to check on them. Then she met Jay on the Jinwa mountain. So he drank tea and was very thankful. He asked her not to go back, but still she went to check on Ki. Then she found Ki when she went down a little more. He was shocked. Ki was shocked seeing her. And he asked, why did you strain yourself so much, Bachendri? Then she replied, I'm a mountain lady and my health is also intact. So why shouldn't I help my co-members so that it will make my journey also easy, your journey also easy. So he smiled and drank the tea and he felt better than Ki. But Ki didn't let her take the kit, mountain kit he was carrying. After some time, they reached the South Col camping location where there was safety and comfort. Next day, the South Pole is also famous as the strongest and toughest place on the earth. Prithvi par bahut adhik kathor, the toughest place on the earth, the South Pole is known as. Agle din main subah 4 baje uthi. Next day, she woke up at 4 a.m. She melted some ice and made tea. She had some biscuit and chocolate as breakfast and she came out of her tent around 5:30 a.m. Ang Dorji was standing outside and no one else was there. अंग दौरजी बिना ऑक्सीजन के ही चढ़ाई करने वाला था ही वॉज गोइंग टू क्लाइंब द माउंटेन द होल एवरेस्ट विदाउट ऑक्सीजन टैंक एंड बिकॉज ऑफ दैट हिज लेग्स वेर फ्रीजिंग सो ही डिडंट वांटेड टू स्टे इन द कोल्ड फॉर लॉन्ग और ही डिडंट वांटेड टू रीच द शिखर कैंप एट द नाइट सो ही वॉन्टेड टू गो टू द टॉप ऑफ द माउंटेन टॉप ऑफ द एवरेस्ट एंड ही वॉन्टेड टू कम बैक टू साउथ कोल कैंप एट द वेरी सेम डे Or else what he will do, he will drop it totally. That was his plan. So he wanted to start climbing soon as so he asked the writer, do you want to join me? It was very really tough to go all the way up and come back on the same day, and if his leg will also freeze, it will make the journey more tough. But still, she had the confidence on Angadorji and also on her climbing skills. And moreover, no one else was ready to climb with her at this early. So finally, she decided to go with him, and around 6:20 a.m., they started their journey. It was breezing a little and it was cold too. Halki halki hawa chal rahi thi. So it was breezing a little and it was very cold. But she was comfortable and safe in her climbing jacket. It was she was feeling warm inside that. So they climbed without the ropes. He would climb at a very fast pace. Angadorji would climb at a very fast pace, and she was able to catch his pace. So it was fine. The frozen ice, jami hui barf. The frozen ice was very hard and slippery, as it was like a carpet made of mirror. They had to use spare tool to walk so that they don't fall down. They'll scrap the ice and they would walk. She kept her every single step very, very carefully. In 2 hours, they reached the Shikhar camp. Angadorji asked the writer, are you tired? She replied, no. Hearing this, he became very happy. And he said, if we maintain the same pace, we would reach the top in the afternoon. And they can come back also. So it was well planned. So Lahatu was coming just behind them, and when they were resting the Dakshini Shikhar, southern top area, he came to them. So after drinking some tea, they started climbing again. Lahatu had brought a nylon rope with him. So Angadorji and Bachendri, the writer, climbed with the help of rope, and Lahatu walked in the middle by holding the rope with just one hand. He was holding not for support, but to keep the balance for them. So that there will be balance, because he was standing in the middle. Then Lahatu noticed that the writer was taking only 2.5 liter of oxygen per minute rather than 4 liter, which was necessary to climb at such a height. So when he changed the rate in her regulator to 4 liter, she noticed that the climbing was much more easier now. Dakshini Shikhar, the speed of the wind on southern peak had increased. Because of the wind, the ice pieces were flying in the wind, making the sight almost zero. They couldn't see what is in front of them. It was like there is no way forward, and if, they would fall down if they walk forward. So it was very, very tough to see something. So she was feeling, meri saans mano ruk gayi thi. She was feeling as if she can't breathe because of the cold weather or because of the ice flying. She felt as if, but there was a feeling that we are going to succeed. We will reach the top of the mountain now. On 23rd May 1984 at 1:07 p.m., she was standing on the top of the Everest. She was the first woman to climb the mountain Everest. Everest Shankhu ki choti par, the top of the mountain was very narrow, and there was not even a place for two people to stand at the same time. So they were very scared to see when they saw around the peak. They got very scared. So first they scraped some ice using a spare tool and pushed their leg inside so that they won't fall down, they won't slip, and they would get a good grip to stand. After this, she sat down and bowed down to Sagar Mata, that is Everest. She kissed it. And while sitting itself, she took out Durga Ma photo and Hanuman Chalisa book from her bag. She wrapped them in a red cloth, did some puja, and put it inside the ice and covered it as if she was marking her foot somewhere. So this moment of joy, she remembered her parents. And when she got up, she bowed to her the way leader, Angadorji. He congratulated her, and she also congratulated him for climbing the Everest twice without oxygen. So he hugged her and said, you really climbed well and I am so happy. Kuch der baad, after some time, Sonam Puljar reached there and started taking photos. In the meantime, Lahatu informed their leader that the four people, Angadoji, Lahato, Shi and Puljar had reached there. Lahato handed over the walkie-talkie to the writer. And the leader said, I would like to thank your parents for your achievement. मैं तुम्हारी अनूठी उपलब्धि के लिए तुम्हारे माता पिता को बधाई देना चाहूँगा. And you have made, I would like to thank your parents for your achievement and our nation is proud of you. And because she was the first woman to climb the Mount Everest, our nation is proud of you. And he also said that now you will go back to a world, a new world, which was totally different from the world which you left when you started this journey. Because for you, the view, the view you will see, your world will be totally different because you have an experience of all the challenges. So you will see the world now very differently. So that's all about the chapter. So she finally completed her journey and all the challenges was nothing in front of the success or the happiness she got after reaching there. So that's all about the chapter. I hope you understood. Please don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Bye-bye.